17 marked. This week we're talking about long runs, a long run routine. So let's get stuck in. Woo!
So we're inside, it is blowing a gale out there. Firstly, check out my lockdown barnet, look. Pretty special, no? So next week I may even take you along when I get this bad boy cut. But most importantly, like I said, I wanted to talk about long runs and long run routine, more importantly than anything else today, which is why I kind of did that sort of B-roll at the start, hopefully showing some of the sort of things and the lengths I go in the morning. Now, I do that every single time on a weekend before I do my long run, which is what I was trying to hopefully show you in that video, whether it came across, I'm not sure. So I do exactly the same thing. And it is so important with a long run to have that routine because it will make it so much easier. And I think the important thing that people don't realise is when you're marathon training, you really want to try and focus some consistency within that training and doing the same thing, especially when you're going out and doing, you know, a long run. So like, you know, 13, 14, 15, 16 miles, to have that established early on in your training, when you get to those sort of later miles, it will make it so much easier. So a couple of tips for long runs, apart from the routine, which is number one, is to plan your route. It's really important to plan your route and have in mind what you're going to do. Now, I know all my routes. Like today, we did that 17 miler, and I know pretty much where I can run from 13 miles up to 22 miles. So I've got that all planned out. And it's really important because I think what can happen is you get lost and things like that, and it can cause anxiety and make the whole long run experience sort of worse than it needs to be. So a real big tip for those long runs, and it doesn't matter if you're training for a marathon, half marathon, 10K, whatever it is, just plan your route before you go out. Another tip for your long run is to have a strategy. Now, plan to do something, to achieve something within that long run, whether it be run out, like, for example, I chose to run this long run, that 17 mile, within zone one and zone two of my heart rate zones, and to practice pacing, so I was well within myself with regards to pacing. It's really important to have a strategy before you go and do that long run, because it will make it so much more interesting, enjoyable, and satisfying, the fact that you've got something to focus on. Right, guys, so the other thing to think about and plan is your fueling strategy. Now, I change my fueling strategy depending on how fast I'm running. So I'll give you an example. If I'm running an easy pace run like I did today, then I'll just fuel every 60 minutes. If I'm running a little bit harder, let's say goal pace, then I'll fuel every 45 minutes. But it's really important to have a strategy before you go out. Again, it's something else to sort of take your mind off why you're out there, what you're doing, and something else to think about while you're out there. But try and get yourself a long run fueling strategy before you go out. Right, guys, another tip is to actually warm up into your run. Take like the first 3K or first couple of miles, whatever it is. It's a nicely, gently ease into that run. One thing it will do is ease back your pace so you're not going off too fast. And also, it will mean you don't go off too slow, because on a long run, sometimes you can actually go off too slow and it sort of has a negative effect. So warming up into your run is quite a good sort of long run tip. Another tip is to keep yourself busy. Now, we spoke about fueling strategies, and I mentioned about that, about keeping yourself occupied with fueling, keeping yourself occupied with regards to having a pacing strategy or a route already in mind so you know where you're going, that sort of stuff. But maybe think about podcasts, music, running with somebody, counting, reciting something, I don't know, whatever you want to do. But try and have something that will keep your mind active, keep yourself busy, because when you get those mid-run blues, which you will on the long run, especially when you start hitting big miles, you want something that you can sort of fall back on and sort of take your mind off of it. Right, just two more tips actually for the long runs. And the first one is sort of build slowly. And what do I mean by that? I mean, build your distance slowly. What tends to happen is you feel awesome and you're going to go, right, I'm going to go out this week. I'm going to run 30 miles. And then you think, oh, actually, I feel all right out here. Oh, I'm going to go and carry on and do 15 miles. You've got to be really disciplined. We did it today. Eddie and I, we felt great. We could have really carried on probably up to 20 miles today, but we wasn't, it's his word, disciplined. And we maintained our distance and we maintained our discipline, and we actually stopped well short. We went in and got a bottle of Coke from Sainsbury's because we didn't need to go and do more than 17 miles. It's just stupid. We want to do those miles gradually over the next 12 weeks, because we're into, as you guys know now, we're into the training plan. So just try and build up slowly. Don't be tempted to go out there and run more than you need to. Remember, you've got a plan for a reason. You want to be building up nice and slowly and stick to that plan. Right, guys, and the last tip today on these long runs is your pace. It's so important to pace your long runs and work well within yourself. Now, today I was working within zone one and zone two of my heart rate zones. I was doing that deliberately because, and if you've not seen my video on easy pace runs, please check it out. You've got to be running these long runs at your sort of easy pace. Put elements in there of your goal marathon pace, and I will do that further down my line, further down the line in my training plan. But we're only in week, what, four or five, whatever it is, I don't even know what it is. But I will start putting elements of that goal pace in there later. But the majority of that run will be done at easy pace, and it's so important. Work well within yourself, build up your stamina, build up your time on your feet. Don't be going out there and running too fast on those easy, on those long runs, because you'll just get injured and you'll just break down, and it's the worst thing you could do. But it's such an easy mistake. We all do it. And sometimes you feel like you're running actually too slow, but have a look at your pacing. Think about what you're meant to be doing. As I say, check that video I did on easy pacing, but it is a really, really big tip to give you. So there you go, guys. That's it for this week, I think. A shame we couldn't go outside, really, but it is just so windy this week. It's ridiculous. Training's going okay. Last week was a bit of a up and down week. This week, back on track. Looking forward to running with Alan this week. Got a couple of sessions booked in as well with regards to speed this week, so I'm looking forward to those. And again, getting back out there with Eddie at the weekend, we're going to try and do some more miles as well. So really feeling confident at the moment, really feeling awesome. I hope you guys are well. Let me know in the comments how your training is going, and I'll catch you guys next week.